Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemy.
This is Navi and part of the instructor team at MakerDemy.
We have already covered Bluetooth Low Energy in one of our previous Learn Technology in 5 Minute videos. We highly recommend you to watch that video from the link given in the video description. In this episode, we will cover an overview of BLE Mesh, how it works and its advantages. The Bluetooth low energy market was estimated at $4.9 billion in the year 2020. This indicates that the popularity of BLE is growing rapidly among the other wireless communication protocols in the IoT domain. The network connection style used in classic Bluetooth is a traditional point-to-point connection that looks like the hub and spoke model known as a star topology. Devices can only talk to the central controller and not directly to each other. BLE was capable of one-to-one and one-to-many topology applications with limited range coverage till July 2017. With the addition of mesh topology in July 2017, the BLE applications are further extended to many-to-many topologies for industries where a wide range of power-efficient sensor networks are required. BLE Mesh is a many-to-many style of communication with provisions for message relay from one device to another to create a flexible mesh topology with multiple potential paths between nodes to ensure message delivery. Mesh functionality is a vital update for new applications in lighting, sensor networking, predictive maintenance, asset tracking, and positioning. Now let's look at how BLE Mesh works. The first process of any BLE mesh network is to add devices to the network. This process is called provisioning, and the device which helps a new device to get connected is called provisioner. Each device connected to the mesh network is called a node. The nodes use messages to communicate with each other. There are four types of nodes in any BLE mesh network. They are as follows. 1. Relay node. This node is an intermediate node that relays messages for other nodes. This helps mesh networks to achieve large coverage and reliability. 2. Proxy node. This node is an intermediate node that enables the communication between mesh networks and BLE-enabled devices that do not have mesh capabilities. 3. Low power node. This is a power-sensitive node that can skip being active all the time and wake itself as programmed and receive messages at the active time. 4. Friend node. This node has a friendship relation with low power node. A message for a low power node is sent to a related friend node, which stores messages for the low power node while it's asleep. When the low power node becomes active, it receives messages from the related friend node. There are different methods of distributing data across mesh networks. BLE Mesh uses managed flooding mesh, which is a simple and reliable approach to distribute messages in larger networks. Reliability is ensured with multiple paths from source to destination, and there is no single point of failure. The reliability of message delivery is ensured in BLE through the following three features. 1. Heartbeat. Each node sends heartbeat messages periodically to inform other nodes that it is active, and it also helps recipient nodes to calculate the number of hops required to send messages to the heartbeat source node. 2. TTL, or time to live. Each message contains a time-to-live value that restricts the number of times the message can be relayed in the network. Each time the message is received and relayed, the TTL value is decremented by 1. A heartbeat message helps the source node to set the correct TTL value. 3. Message cache. Each node maintains a message cache for recently received messages. Whenever a node receives a message, it checks the locally cached list of relayed messages and ignores if already present. Finally, let's look at why BLE Mesh enabled solutions are preferred. 1. Global interoperability. The products developed by one vendor works with the products manufactured by another vendor seamlessly without additional efforts. 2. Great backward compatibility. With the help of the proxy nodes, BLE Mesh is backward compatible with all BLE enabled devices that do not support mesh protocol. 3. Cost effectiveness. Most of smartphones support BLE 4.0 or even 5.0. Hence, BLE mesh-enabled solutions can easily leverage mobile phones without needing customers to purchase additional hardware device. 4. End-to-end security. In BLE mesh, security is mandatory and can't be switched off. It provides complete process security design starting from the provisioning process to processing messages. 5. Power efficiency. BLE Mesh uses Bluetooth low energy with the friendship concept to keep the power consumption optimized compared to the other mesh technologies. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.